for about 27 degrees. Today, it's Dakota College About No Time and somebody brand new to the station. Good morning, Linda. How are you?
I'm great.
Yeah, I'll give you this microphone here a little bit more.
All right.
There, that's much better. Now we can hear you. Linda Burbage is here from Dakota College About No. What's your official title with the college, Linda?
I am an instructor in the agriculture program.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Now, you're brand new to the college. Can you give us some information about yourself?
Yeah, so I originally hail from Park Rapids, Minnesota. Okay. I was raised on a dairy farm out there.
Okay.
So, yeah, no stranger to hard work.
Right, of course, and, yes.
Yeah, so I went to NDSU to get my bachelor's degree, my master's degree, and I was in ag econ there,
okay,
agribusiness. So after that, I kind of decided, well, you know, I really like learning, mm-hmm, and it was just, you know, there weren't great times in the job market at that point. So I went on and did some graduate work at Kansas State University. So
okay,
I got my PhD from K-State in 2010.
Okay, so you're really no stranger to travel either.
No, not at all.
You've kind of been around the area.
Yes.
So you lived in Mohall for a little bit too and stuff?
Yes. So my husband's originally from Mohall.
Okay.
So about 4 years ago, I suppose it was, he got an opportunity to move back to that area.
Okay.
He got a good job opportunity, and so we moved back to Mohall.
Okay. And now, do you live in town here then, or do you still commute?
I commute right now.
Okay,
yeah. We still live in Mohall, so
okay,
I have some early mornings and
of course
a long drive.
But of course, yes.
You know what? It's all worth it.
But and happy to have you back in the area here.
Yeah.
Then. All right. So welcome here. So agriculture management and the tech program at DCB. What's the program all about?
So this program, actually, we are in conjunction with the ag programs in Devil's Lake at Lake Region State and, mm-hmm, Williston State College. So our program's brand new this fall. Of course, they've had programs. Williston's is still relatively new. Lake Region's has been around a while, but mm-hmm, our students can take a variety of courses. So I have students taking classes from Williston right now. I teach classes. They get received at Williston. So we basically together, we're stronger. We have a wider,
sure,
variety of topics we can teach because, as you know, ag is really varied in the topics you can talk,
yes,
about. You can talk about crops. You can talk about livestock. You can talk about business. And so it's hard to find one person or two people even who can do all of that. So by joining together in this consortium is what we're calling it, the North Dakota Ag Consortium, we're able to teach a variety of classes to students and, you know, increase their skills they're able to gain and the, mm-hmm, knowledge they're able to gain.
And the response has been pretty good so far?
Yeah, it has been. We've got quite a few students already. We have several on campus I know who are interested in maybe switching. And
nice.
we've had quite a few visits for prospective students coming through.
Okay, well, that's great. Yeah. And that's the bottom line.
Yes.
You know, you have to offer something that's going to be it's going to be well received.
Yes.
And so far, it's been great then, huh?
Yes, it has been. Yeah.
What kind of degrees can we expect to get from this program?
So right now we have three options. We have a certificate program, mm-hmm, an AAS program, and then an AS program. So the AS program is for students who know they want to go on to a four-year, and so they're just taking their first 2 years of generals here. So we can kind of help them and guide them and say, okay, if you're in ag, you know, do you have a specialty, like maybe you're into crops, maybe you're into,
okay,
business, and we can get them the right mix of general education credits to get them there. And they can take some ag classes too, so that they're still connected with their, you know, true passion.
Okay.
And then the AAS is for students who probably, you know, they're not sure, but they're definitely interested in ag. And so they might have, you know, a career focus in mind. Maybe they want to go into sales or agronomy. You know, we can help them by getting them some gen eds to just help,
sure,
build their general skills. And then we can give them the ag skills they want.
So give them a platform,
yes,
to start off with and then kind of a launching pad, if you will.
Yes.
Very
and then
cool.
It's flexible too, because if they change their mind and decide they want to go on for a little more schooling, you know, the AAS allows them to do that. They've,
okay,
got a good base started.
Okay. And then speaking of like program plans,
yes,
what would that entail?
So our plans for the future really are just to grow the program. So we want to get out there and do a lot of recruiting.
Sure.
So in the spring, I have some visits planned for some different high schools in the area, mm-hmm. or, the ag program specifically, but also visiting with the FFA groups in the area. So we'll be doing quite a bit of that. You'll probably see me out and about making some contacts for that.
Okay.
And we'll be developing some new courses. So even this spring, we've got some new courses we're going to be offering at the college. We'll have agricultural marketing and agricultural finance.
Okay, so that's obviously important as well.
Yes.
To keep evolving the program.
Yes.
So yeah, so you don't want to just sit back and rest on your laurels and on your haunches. You want to keep building it.
Yes, absolutely.
Perfect. All right. And so as we look at the plans for the future for this program, what about the future of ag itself?
Well, I think the future of ag is very promising, especially mm-hmm. for people who are looking for careers, because a lot of the industries, they're seeing lots of retirements and nobody there to fill the gaps.
Okay.
So there's going to be a lot of job opportunities there for people who are interested in ag.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's great for students because, I hate to say it, but times like these actually give us good college enrollment, because students who maybe were thinking, I want to stay and farm, they're going, okay, well, crop prices aren't good and we're not feeling really great about
maybe
this.
Maybe after the year we've had. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So what's the next best thing? If you can't be farming, you can be talking about farming and working in an industry that supports farmers. And so for ag, I think it's really important, especially where we're seeing lots of retirements in those industries too. There's going to be great careers available. And these are great jobs too. I always tell students, these jobs, they pay well, usually, and, people have to eat, so you've got some job security there.
Right.
And in addition, they can take you anywhere. If you want to live in a rural area, you can live in a rural area, and there's usually lots of ag jobs. If you want to move up and go to a bigger city, there's plenty of jobs in industries like trading or grain or ag finance.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And, if you want to live internationally, there's plenty of jobs in trade and things like that. So
okay.
It really can take you anywhere you want to go.
And you got to start somewhere.
Yes.
So
absolutely.
Why not start at Dakota College of Botany?
Absolutely.
If we have any questions, we want a little more information about this program. How
yes.
Can I get a hold of you, Linda?
Yeah. You can contact me. My office phone is 228-5442.
Mm-hmm.
You can also visit our website if you go to dakotacollege.edu and look under academics and programs. Agriculture is right there up front. We're alphabetically first, so you know what? No need to look any farther. There we are.
That's right.
So you can check that out. We've got our fact sheet up and some program curriculum. We're working on changing that a little bit to make it just a little bit more flexible for students. Because, like I said, ag draws in everything. We draw in lots of different skills. And so if we have students who know they're interested in business and they want to take human resources management too, we're willing to allow them that flexibility.
I love the way you said people got to eat.
Yes, they do.
Gotta eat. And job security is fairly high in the agricultural business. So.
Yes, it is.
Appreciate it, Linda. Thank you so much today, all right?
All right,
let's
thanks.
Get you back soon, all right?
All right.
I need a high five.
Sounds great.
Yes. All right. Thank you very much. 8:34 into our next 7-day forecast we go. It's coming up.